killed after coming under fire from police units in Hololulu on Monday. The police, however, say it was a firefight with armed men who defied orders to subject themselves to questioning. Our senior correspondent David Santos joins us for the latest. David, it is such a tragic incident, and our hearts go out to the military as well as to the families of the slain soldiers. But are we getting a clearer picture of what really happened?
Well, Ria, both the police and the military are issuing conflicting versions of the incident. A Mindanao Regional Military Command issuing a statement overnight saying the policemen shot their men dead. As to why the police would do that, Lieutenant General Sirilito Sobejana of the AFP Western Mindanao Command admits the motive seems to be unclear. But an initial report of the Sulu PNP says four men in plain clothes and on board an unmarked vehicle introduced themselves as soldiers in a checkpoint Monday afternoon. They were instructed to proceed to the Jolo police station so their identities could be verified. Now, instead, they defied the order and decided to leave, which prompted the police to go after them. Now, the police claim in their report the suspects engaged them in a firefight, but they managed to shoot all of them dead. Now, those four suspects apparently turned out to be members of the Army's 11th Infantry Division, the main military unit in the island, who were doing surveillance work in Jolo at that time. Now, two of the four Army men are officers, a major and a captain. Their names are being withheld until their families are being notified. Ria.
David, how do we see this being resolved since all those involved are security forces?
Well, Major General Corleto Vindua is the commander of the Army's 11th Infantry Division. He's insisting that his men were unarmed at that time, implying that his men were defenseless when the police, in his words, gunned them down, which, of course, is contrary to the police report. Now, Defense Chief Delvin Lorenzana called the incident very unfortunate. They have requested the NBI, the National Bureau of Investigation, to do an independent probe into the incident. General Sobejana of the Western Mindanao Command also saying the NBI is stepping into the picture so we can get to the bottom of this incident while ensuring that there will be no escalation of hostilities between the two forces in Jolo.
David, based on your experience from years of covering Sulu, how important is it for our security leaders to find a way to de-escalate this tension now between the AFP and the PNP?
Well, Ria, this is not the first time this kind of an incident happened in Jolo. No, in 2002, the police and the military also figured in a bloody gun battle in Jolo that killed 16 people. Most of them were members of the Philippine Marines. Now, that drove a wedge between the military and the police as well as to the community in Jolo that supported both sides. Now, for some time, there was so much distrust and divisiveness between the AFP and the PNP, and more killings happened in the aftermath of that incident, prompting officials to order the pullout of the Marines in Jolo just to diffuse the tension. Now, obviously, Ria, with the recurring problem of terrorism and violent extremism in Sulu now, plus the COVID pandemic, it is very crucial that leaders find a resolution to this incident without having to divide further these two forces. Ria.
All right, thank you so much for that, David Santos.